everybody, I am Kenya and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am a real estate agent and a property manager, so most of the time I do talk about rentals on my channel. So I always get this question on my YouTube channel: how do I get into property management without having any experience? Now I'm going to say that getting into property management without any experience is going to be pretty hard. I'm going to tell you that. Now I worked as a real estate agent doing a lot of luxury rentals for my broker for about a little over a year. So therefore I had that on my resume, so when I went to apply for jobs, that was something that was on my resume so I could showcase, yeah, I do have experience in the luxury market. Especially if you want to do luxury rentals, they want to know, like, you know, are you able to, you know, deal with luxury clientele? Like, are you a fit for it? Are you able to close deals? So if you're going into, like, you want to do like property management, especially luxury property management, they're gonna want to see that type of background and experience. Now what I will say is, if you go for smaller companies, now my company, they are investors and they did recently build one property, so I will say that they are now developers, but they are a smaller company, so it was easier for me to get my foot in the door to, you know, get into property management. So I would say look for smaller companies, maybe look for smaller buildings. Maybe it may not be luxury right off the bat. Maybe if you see something online, somebody needs you to, you know, they need a manager or leasing consultant for like a small building, you know, just the regular building, maybe it's garden apartments, I would say apply for that. But I also did work for a temp agency before I started working at the company I am now. So from working under my broker, I started with the temp agency, got some experience there, and my temp agency was I worked at a property that was a lease-up, and it was also luxury. So when I went to the interview for my current position, I was able to show my resume, okay, I did, you know, do rentals, you know, under my broker, I did a lot of luxury rentals there, and I also have experience with this temp agency, which is a lease-up, and I am doing luxury rentals there. And now, as I'm looking for jobs, because I always have to stay abreast, I'm keeping my options open and I'm always looking, of course, because I know that there's a better position out there with way more money that I could be working at. So when I'm looking around online, there are a lot of tax credit properties going up. Now, I don't know why people don't know about these tax credit properties, but there are so many tax credit properties going up all throughout New Jersey, all around like Brooklyn, especially the Bronx, like I mentioned in another video, which I was offered a job in the Bronx, but I didn't like the neighborhood or the properties, and I was like, no ma'am, now I'm bougie, I don't want to do lower rentals anymore. So and now they want you to be certified. You have to have, you know, a lot of certifications, and, you know, being able to, you know, process tax credit applications, people that are doing, you know, are applying for affordable housing. So that's going to be another thing that you won't have experience doing if you never worked for like Section 8 or low income housing tax credit programs. Like, and there's so many certifications that you have to be able to, you know, process applicants and put them in these, you know, apartments. So that's another roadblock that people may face if you don't have any experience. Now, like I said, I would suggest that you start out either, you know, get a real estate license, you know, secure some rentals, do it for like a little over a year, you know, show that you have some longevity, show that you actually are interested in, you know, the field, and that's that. You know, or try to find like a temp agency, because I feel like in New Jersey, especially Northern New Jersey and New York City, they're not going to hire a lot of people for leasing professional jobs if you just don't have any experience at all. Even if you said, I worked in sales, I sold cars for 10 years, you know, I sold air conditioners for 10 years, it's not the same as working in, you know, property management. So it is kind of hard to get into property management. So I suggest, like I said, become a real estate agent, do rentals, you know, try to get some luxury rentals in there. Just don't do all lower end ones. Try to do some higher end ones if you can. And I feel like working in luxury real estate is totally different from working in like just regular, your lower end real estate. And I'm going to talk about that in a whole nother video, because you have to come correct, honey. Correct if you want to work in luxury real estate, period. The type of people you're going to encounter are going to be totally different. And you have to be, you know, confident and just, you know, able to just deal with that type of you know, that market of people. But like I said, I'm gonna get into it in a whole nother video. So subscribe so that you could, you know, be here when I upload that video and give you the tea on it, okay? So with that being said, I hope that I gave you, you know, the information that you did need for it. So with that being said, I want to thank you guys for kicking it with me today. Thank you for clicking on my video. If you're not subscribed already, do so on your way out. And I will see you guys in my next YouTube video soon.